Hello friends and welcome to this video. We are with the fifth chapter to learn digital image processing. The chapter is titled Image Enhancement in Frequency Domain. So as the previous chapter and the current chapter are dedicated to learn the various techniques for image enhancement. Enhancement, a kind of improvement to gather more and more information from the image as a two-dimensional signal. In the previous chapter, we have seen the methodologies when the working is into the spatial domain only, and in this chapter, the working is only in frequency domain here. So we started this chapter to see what exactly the Fourier transformation means and the corresponding frequency domain representation here. And here we have the study of frequency domain filtering techniques. So as we have the two types of the filtering, the low pass filtering and high pass filtering. Low pass filtering we have seen of the three types: ideal case and for the practical cases, Gaussian and Butterworth low pass filters here. We have also seen the MATLAB demonstrations for the same. And now for high pass filtering, as we are covered with the ideal type and the Gaussian type, the last one is to be addressed. That it is in the video Butterworth high pass filter. So what exactly is the filter function and how do we have the representation of the same in three dimension and two dimensional case, and what is the effect of Butterworth high pass filtering onto a certain input image, we shall see in this video. So let us begin with the topic. So here we start with our topic, the topic titled Butterworth high pass filter here. So as we have covered for the low pass filters, ideal, Gaussian, Butterworth, and also for high pass filters, the first two cases, ideal and Gaussian, we have for the Butterworth high pass filter, the filter function. So in the transform domain, we have the notation by using the capital letter H as a function of u comma v here. So this is transform domain representation, or you can say frequency domain representation. Obviously our chapter is image enhancement in frequency domain. So h as a function of u comma v is equal to 1 upon 1 plus d0 by d of u comma v, and this ratio is having the power 2 multiplied by small n. So in this representation of the filter function of the Butterworth type for high pass filtering operation, we have h as a function of u comma v dependent on the two most important parameters. The one is small n, that is the order, and d0, that is the cutoff distance, as we have discussed in the previous filter functions also. So let us first of all visualize the three-dimensional and two-dimensional nature of the Butterworth high-pass filters here. So on the left-hand side, we have the representation of h as a function of u comma v, the three-dimensional representation of the Butterworth high-pass filter. So u and v, the two axes you can see at the bottom, whereas there it is the third axis, which is mutually perpendicular to u and v. At the middle, we visualize the two-dimensional representation of the filter function. You can see at the center of this plane that is formed by the u and v, the two-dimensional axis in the frequency domain here, we see the complete darkness, and gradually there it is a change and we come to the complete brightness very soon. So this is as per the mathematical expression we have shown on the previous slide. And here we have a plot of h of u comma v versus d of u comma v in the last graphical representation. Now let us visualize the effect of carrying out Butterworth high pass filter with the value of n to be the order of the function and d0 to be the cutoff the distance. So let us have first of all the original image, which is of the dimensions 500 by 500 pixels. In this original image, we have different objects, I can say, or the different components. You see, there are vertical bars with different shades. There are the squares with different dimensions. There are circles with different shades, that means the various pixel intensities. The text letter small a here, and there are certain rectangular shapes where there it is density of the pixels of the white or the dark pixels, you say, in variation here. And the corresponding frequency domain, the representation of this original image of the dimension 500 by 500 can be shown on the right hand side. So this commonly we call to be the Fourier spectrum. And below we have the result of carrying out Butterworth high pass filtering over the original image, where the order n is equal to 2 and the cutoff distance d0 is equal to 15. Now, keeping the order of the Butterworth filter the same, n is equal to 2, but increasing the cutoff distance d0 by doubling it. So d0, instead of making 15, if we make it to 30 here, so here it is the corresponding result, Butterworth of the order 2, but d0 this time it is equal to 30. If we increase it a lot, so taking the same order, n is equal to 2, but d0, the cutoff distance to the value 80, here we have the corresponding result. So here you can see, with the help of the Butterworth filtering, the edges of whatever the components we have in the original image, we can find out here. So initially, with d0 to be equal to 15, the edges were little bit blurred. There it was not so easiness for distincting the edges where we have the change of the various components here. But as we have the d0 increase from 15 to 30, from 30 to 80, we see the change. And to look at the various results, we have to check the optimum value here. Now, as in the family of the filters in the frequency domain, we have this topic to be the last one here. Let us have the comparison of the high pass filters. We have the three types: the ideal high pass filter, then Gaussian high pass filter, and the current topic, that it is Butterworth high pass filter. So let us have the comparison on the two-dimensional plane. So here we have the spatial representation of the typical ideal frequency domain high pass filter with the gray level profile on the top here, whereas the corresponding spatial representation of the typical Butterworth frequency domain high pass filter with gray level profile, and then the Gaussian type here we have. So at the middle we have for the Butterworth frequency domain high pass filter and the gray level profile, and at last we have the Gaussian type here. Now, on the previous slide, for the original image discussed thereupon, we had discussion on to the various results carried by using the Butterworth filtering by keeping the same order but varying the cutoff distance d0 here. Now let us take that original image again with the dimensions 500 by 500 here, the corresponding frequency domain representation, what we call Fourier spectrum. Now this image, if it is operated by ideal high pass filter with the same cutoff distance d0 is equal to 15, here it is the result. Now you compare this result to the result that is obtained by using the Gaussian type of the high pass filtering with the same cutoff distance d0. See, it is quite improved. And on comparing this result and the two to that of the Butterworth order, having n is equal to 2 but d0 is equal to 15, you see a great improvement here. So here it was our topic, Butterworth high pass filtering. So this is one of the image enhancement technique to be performed in the frequency domain here. By the next lecture, we shall continue into the same chapter, where we shall be having the demonstration of the current technique that we have discussed. So the topic, it will be MATLAB program, Butterworth high pass filter. Thank you.